Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, the laws of activities prohibited on Shabbos. And today we're speaking about two malachas, boina, building, and we're also going to be speaking about chayrish, which is plowing. And we'll see the connection between the two. Also, the chabines habayis, a person is not allowed to sweep the house with a broom. Now, we're talking over here about a broom, about a floor that is made out of dirt. And when you sweep the floor of dirt, you are leveling out the ground. When you level out the ground, so it's on one level, it's baina, on one level, it's building, because you are making the ground better. On the other hand, it's also like a told of chayrish, of plowing, because you are moving away the dirt and you're plowing down the ground. Afilu merutza ba'avanim ha'minasarim, even if the floor was made out of stones or wood planks, and therefore you're not going to be leveling out the ground when you sweep, nevertheless, you're not going to be allowed to use the broom and sweep the house, even on that floor. Now, even though, the Mishnah Berurah writes like this, even though that stone or wood is not going to become leveled when it gets swept, but Chazal came along and they really made what's called the loy plug. They said that we're not going to allow any sweeping to take place, because if you think that you could sweep a hard floor, you'll end up thinking that you could sweep a floor of dirt as well. However, the Be'er Halacha, which is the Chavetz Chaim, he writes that if most of the homes in the town where you live have finished floors, which means it's either made out of wood, it's made out of cement, it's made out of tiles, as we have in our day and age, then since we're never concerned that you're going to go and sweep dirt floors, you'd be allowed to sweep the floor in such a case. So therefore, that means that for us, when everybody lives in a house on the inside where the floors themselves are finished and they are hard and there's no dirt around, therefore you'd be allowed to sweep, not a problem. However, when it comes to asking a non-Jew to sweep even a floor of dirt, that he would be allowed to do such a thing. Because he has no prohibition to sweep however he wants. If a person does some kind of shinui, a deviation from the usual way that he brooms, you have goose feathers instead of a broom, then you'd be allowed to sweep the floor, a dirt floor even, through a Jew. Okay, but again, our day and age, when all the floors are finished off and they're hard, there's no prohibition over here. You're allowed to sweep. It's not going to be an issue. Lo yishashveis beraglay roik sha'al gabia karka. A person should not spit with his foot that is on the ground. Why? Because if spit is on the ground, assuming that the ground is dirt, when you rub it in with your heel, you're now leveling out the ground. So we said you're not allowed to do such a thing. It's baina, it's chayresh, you can't do such things. But if you're just walking and you happen to step on that spit, then we say that was unintentional, and therefore you're not trying to level out the ground, or you're not going to level out the ground, there it's not a problem. Once again, though, according to what we said in the Be'er Halacha, by the case of sweeping a floor, if all the floors in town are finished floors, and therefore you're allowed to sweep the floors, so too over here, if all of the floors are finished, and a person spits on the floor, he spits on the street, it's all concrete, it's asphalt, all different things that we have there, so therefore, if you want to rub out the spit so that nobody should see it, you'd be allowed to do such a thing. We're not concerned of leveling out the ground. Have a wonderful day.